warming, except your children. Good evening, everyone. My name is Padma Faraz Hoti. I'm a 14-year-old climate activist from Mardan. I'm working as a child activist since 2014, and I started climate activism in October 2019. And since then, I've arranged several plantation drives, cleanup drives, and seminars for the awareness of climate change. Today, I am here because a few decades ago, the strong, devoted mothers of my beloved province, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, were happy and contented over the birth of their beloved children. Contented with the surety that their children will cleanse their body with fresh azure water and will heal in the fresh air of the province. A surety that their child will run and play with healthy mind and soul. A surety that her child will wake up in the morning to enjoy the fresh morning breeze with birds singing and chanting songs of happiness. A surety that her child will grow into a mighty Pashtun with all the freshness of food, water, and beautiful environment around. But respected audience, everything has seemed to be turned and twisted, maybe with a blink of an eye. No, certainly not. The problem has been there, slow and persistent, since quite a lot of time. But unfortunately, it has made itself visible with a fierce outcome. Do you know what the problem is which is crippling my province and its blooming flowers? It is the global warming, the pollution, the climate change. A province being as small as a ripple in the ocean is becoming a great hub of global warming and hazard to the climate. The increasing demand of vehicles, the uncountable installments of factories leading to carbon dioxide emissions is the major cause of air pollution. This worsened air quality due to dust, smoke, and pollution in the air has increased the asthma episodes in the children of my province. Respected audience, the talk over here is not just about the asthma attacks in the children, but it's also about the increasing risk of lung cancer and bronchitis in the children of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Highest cancer rates has been said to be from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, which is a matter of great concern. While children with asthma are a story of every second house, which was once the illness of an old age. Have you ever wondered what all this will lead to? It will lead to a weak and fatigued generation of my province, with increasing risk of mental and physical health. Do you think children as fragile as a glass being vulnerable to the heat will bear the rising temperature? No, certainly not. But unfortunately, the graph is on the rise. According to a latest survey, there is a tremendous rise of frequent visits of the children of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa to psychologists. As extreme weather of my province, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, deaths due to heat waves, children are facing difficulties in controlling their emotions and are becoming a victim of depression and anxiety, while my heart goes out to them all. Respected audience, the climate change has become a cancer to my province, acting slowly and steadily, endeavoring the jewels of my Pakhtunkhwa. How can you sit and watch the future of my province becoming a victim to this all? 25 years ago, people could not be blamed or excused for not knowing much or doing much about the climate. But today we have no excuse. We have to rise for the uplift of our future generations. Another important thing is that climate change is a part of the Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs. Goal 13, the associated targets of SDG 13, focuses on the integration of climate change measures into national policies. And let me remind you that Pakistan affirmed its commitment to the 2030 agenda for its Sustainable Development Goals into 2015. Pakistan was first such country to do so. Now it's time to practically do whatever we committed. I'm really thankful to the Prime Minister Imran Khan for creating awareness through the plantation drives, but I would urge the Prime Minister, the Education Minister, and the Climate Minister to make the climate education necessary in every educational institute. And if you think that the climate is less important than the economy, then try holding your breath by counting your money. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. so much pathfinders have reflected the stark reality that people are facing in Kyoto. Now moving towards our last panelist, Ms. Delhi. She is from Kazaya Degree College, Quetta, and she will be telling us about her perspective through the Quetta and Balochistan movements on climate change and its impact on overall the movements.
Good evening and assalamu alaikum to the honorable chief guests and all respected ones sitting here. First of all, thanksgiving praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because we are gathered here through his blessings. I am also grateful to the RDF who has given me opportunity to sit here today. My name is Tehim Irfan. I am from Quetta, Balochistan. In this opportunity, I would like to deliver my speech entitled Climate Change and Children's Future. So, what is climate change? Climate change is a global phenomenon of climate transformation characterized by the changes in the usual climate of the planet regarding wind, precipitation, temperature that are especially caused by human activities as a result of unbalancing the weather of the earth. The sustainability of the planet's ecosystem is under threat, as well as the future of humankind and the stability of the global economy. Ladies and gentlemen, Islam teaches followers to take care of the earth. Muslims believe that humans should act as guardians or khalifa of the earth. This concept of stewardship is a powerful one and was used in the Islamic declaration of climate change to propel an environment policy in Muslim countries. In fact, Muslims need to look no further than the Quran for guidance, where there are approximately 200 verses concerning the environment. Muslims taught that greater indeed that the creation of man is the creation of the heavens and the earth. The reality is that nothing could be more Islamic than the protecting the world's most precious creation, the earth. So, how climate change affects on children's life? As we all know that children are not little adults. Their health is impacted more directly by climate change. Do you know what? हम ये है जो अपने साथ साथ बच्चों की जिंदगी को भी खतरे में डाल रहे हैं, कैसे? हाउ? हमने इस जमीन को जिस पर हम रहते हैं गंदगी और नजाकत का अंबार बना दिया है और इस बात से हम बिल्कुल बेखबर हैं कि इसके असरात हमारे आने वाली नस्ल, हमारे आने वाले जनरेशन के ऊपर क्या पड़ सकते हैं. जैसे कि जंगलों में दरख्तों को इस बेदर्दी से काटा जा रहा है, इसके असरात मौसमों पर साफ छिड़कने लगे हैं. हवा जो सभी जानदारों के लिए जरूरी है, वो कारखानों की चिमनियों से निकलते हुए धुओं और केमाई जड़बगाहों से छोड़े गए गैस, कचरे और सड़कों पर चलती हुई गाड़ियों से आलूदा हो चुकी है कि इंसान इसकी वजह से मुख्तलिफ बीमारियों में मुबतला हो रहे हैं. इस जमीन में रहने वाली सबसे अफजल मखलूक इंसान वो ही है जो इस सब चीज़ों को तबाही की तरफ ले जा रही है. ये तबाहकुन माहौल बहुत ही बड़ा खतरा बन गया है जिसकी वजह से बच्चों में बढ़ने की सलाहियत, बच्चों में ग्रोइंग की सलाहियत कम हो रही है. इन सब वजूहत की सिर्फ एक ही वजह है कि हम कुदरती जिंदगी गुजारने से बहुत ही दूर हो गए हैं और सनअती पैदावार गैर फिक्री तरीके से पैदावार बढ़ाने के लिए बगैर सोचे समझे तरक्की के नाम पर चल रहे हैं. अब तो आप बात करते हैं व्हाट कॉजेस क्लाइमेट चेंज. मैं आप लोगों को तीन चीज़ें बताना चाहूँगी जिसकी वजह क्लाइमेट चेंज में बहुत ज़्यादा है. नंबर वन, बर्निंग फॉसिल फ्यूल्स. नंबर टू, डिफॉरेस्टेशन. एंड नंबर थ्री इज फार्मिंग. सो व्हाट थिंग्स प्रिवेंट क्लाइमेट चेंज? स्मॉल थिंग्स इन योर ओन होम कैन मेक अ डिफरेंस टू. ट्राई स्विचिंग टू एनर्जी सेविंग लाइट बल्ब, वॉकिंग इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग द कार. फर्स्ट, सबको पता है कि हम जो गाड़ियाँ वगैरह चलाती हैं सड़कों पर, इसकी पॉल्यूशन, उसके जो धुआं और गाड़ियों का जो फ्यूल वगैरह है, उसकी वजह से बहुत सारे हमारी फिजा में अलूदगी आ रही है. हमारी हवा की वजह से हमारी हवा में अलूदगी आ रही है. थर्डली, ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक आइटम्स व्हेन यू आर नॉट यूजिंग देम, रिसाइकलिंग एंड रीयूजिंग योर फूड वेस्ट. मैं जो हूँ यहाँ वाले की तवज्जो चाहूँगी, सम ऑफ द थिंग्स पेरेंट्स कैन डू टू प्रोटेक्ट योर किड्स. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट आई कैन मेक टू पेरेंट्स इज दैट through taking actions to decarbonize in your own lives and community, we can improve our children's health today and provide a more livable climate tomorrow. So here are 5 things parents can do. Choose walking, biking or public transit whenever possible, and consider carpooling. If you are buying a car, find one with better fuel economy. The more gas a car burns per mile, the more harmful air pollution generates. Number two, substitute a red meal once in a week with something vegetarian. Beef is a far more carbon intensive than almost any other food source. It also tends to be unhealthy. Number three, reduce, reuse, and recycle. A timeless piece of advice, the more we buy new, the greater our carbon footprint. Much of what we consume is made overseas, but the air pollution generated through production doesn't stay there, it comes to us. Number four, get involved. Many towns and cities want to decarbonize, in fact they are leading on this issue. And parents can play a role in shaping those efforts. When your neighborhood is getting redeveloped, ask that plans to be made it easier to walk and bike safely. Ask for green space and access to public transit. These actions will benefit everyone's health and especially the health of our children. आखिर में मैं एक गवर्नमेंट से जो हूँ गुजारिश करना चाहूँगी, अगर तो सुबह की तरफ नज़र दौड़ाई जाए तो मैं बलूचिस्तान से हूँ और बलूचिस्तान सबसे पस्त मानता है। मेरी गवर्नमेंट से गुजारिश है कि बलूचिस्तान की तरफ पर खसूसी तवज्जो दी जाए। बलूचिस्तान की ज़मीन पूरी तरह से खुश्क है, हर जगह बंजर है, वहाँ भी दरख्तों को लगाने और पौधे उगाने का कोई इंतज़ाम किया जाए ताकि बच्चों वहाँ के बच्चों को भी अच्छी फिजा मिल सके। शुक्रिया।